Hi, I'm Paul Yuknovich, and I'd like to introduce to you one of the easiest and most convenient ways to get started and do your actual dev test tasks inside of Windows Azure. What we've done is we've created a set of virtual machine images that contain Visual Studio 2013 Professional, Premium, and Ultimate versions. You can provision these very quickly, and you can do a number of your dev test tasks. Let's get started and build our first Visual Studio virtual machine. I'm in the Windows Azure Management Portal. We'll go to the new command and we'll create a new virtual machine from the gallery. Now, as an MSDN subscriber, I see an additional set of images that are a benefit to me as an MSDN subscriber that are used for dev test. And as I scroll down, I see three Visual Studio virtual machine images. I have Professional, Premium, and Ultimate. Let's work with Ultimate. And now I can, like any other virtual machine, simply type in a few parameters to provision this virtual machine. For development, I would recommend starting with a large virtual machine. And if you want to work with SharePoint or SharePoint farm topologies, I would even increase that to an extra large. We'll type in a username or password. This is what we'll use later to log in using Remote Desktop. And I can see that based on that cloud, based on that virtual machine name, the cloud service name has been chosen. Let's make sure we put this in the right location or data center. And I can choose which storage account I'd like my VM to live in. And if I plan to do auto-scale or availability tests, I could also create an availability set. For now, we'll leave that unset. And the last thing we see, there are a number of options for endpoints that are exposed on the VM by default. We recommend you keep the defaults at least to have Remote Desktop and Remote PowerShell. And then you can additionally add ports such as WebDeploy or anything else that you need for your development purposes. And we can hit complete, and we can see that image is already provisioning. And this process will take several minutes. So what I'd like to do instead is show you an image that's already running. And while we're still here in the portal, I want to call out that my MSDN subscription is giving me a number of hours and dollars that I can use. So I already have a built-in benefit to try out the scenario and to do my dev test. All right, so I have another image that was created with the exact same parameters. I'll select it, and I'll say connect. This will remote desktop into the image. We'll use that same username and password. And now that I'm logged in, I can see I effectively have a virtual desktop to do my development and to do my testing. And this has the RTM version of Visual Studio 2013. We also include a number of utility scripts that we think will help you have a working development environment right away. So by default, we've installed IIS, and we've installed SQL Server Express so that you can do a number of web development and cloud development tasks that are web-centric. We also give you a set of deployment scripts that help you take the environment further. So for example, if you want to set this environment up to do SharePoint farm development, you can simply run this PowerShell script, or you can customize the PowerShell script. And now we've evolved this topology to support SharePoint farms. Also, if you want to use an Active Directory and use domains, we even give you the additional logic to go create that Active Directory and federate the SharePoint in that domain. So there's a number of utilities for you here that help you get started and take your development process sooner. The way we think about this image, it's a great way to get started with Visual Studio development and cloud development. It's also really great for a number of maintenance situations. For example, if you have different environments and different topologies, you can save off different virtual machine disks, and you can suspend them when you're not using it so that you're not paying. And at a later time, you can start up that image, you can do development, you can get latest on your source code, do that maintenance operation, and then spin it back down. So it just gives you a really fluid option for dev test. The last thing I'd like to show is inside of Visual Studio, your life is a bit better for working with these environments as well. So the same environments that we've created using the portal are showing up in the Server Explorer under the Windows Azure node now that I've signed in to Visual Studio. I can right-click on any of the VMs, and I can also connect using Remote Desktop. Or, as I mentioned, when I'm done doing my development, it's a good idea to shut down the image. That will suspend and deactivate the compute and basically stop using compute hours. And now I'm not paying anymore for that active development, and I save costs. As we saw, it's very easy to provision and access one of our Visual Studio environments inside of Windows Azure, which means we can do our dev and test tasks at any time, anywhere in the world.